Tim and Willy in the morning.
All right, as I mentioned earlier, the American Idol tour with Kelly and Tito and Jumanji. Who are all these?
Jumanji.
All the people, not just the winners.
Tyra Banks.
Kelly Clarkson won, but there was also Justin. That's what I'm thinking of.
Justin.
Fraggle Rock. And they're out on tour, you know, and they're singing their songs live for the people. And we have the number of the hotel room, and we think we can get a hold of Kelly Clarkson a little bit later. We're going to try it. But I thought let's have a little bit of a competition this morning, and let you try to be an American. It's easier than it looks, folks. I don't know what all the hoopla was about.
Yeah.
But you got to call us and sing from your shower. Now we have, this is the mom of somebody, right?
Yes, I'm mom.
And your daughter, did she watch all of the episodes?
Yes.
And she's very familiar with all the songs then.
Yeah.
And was she happy with the outcome? Was she rooting for Kelly?
Yeah, she was rooting for Kelly.
Who wasn't?
Yeah. Justin's parents?
Yeah.
I don't know. I think they caved at the last and decided to vote for
her. Oh, really?
Yeah.
Okay, well, who is the singer?
Her name is Andrea.
And she's a young lady. She's like 11, did you say?
She's 11.
Okay. But, and she has a towel on, so this it won't get inappropriate in any way.
No, she didn't have a towel, and she's in the shower.
Okay, well, are you going to sneak in? We'll close our eyes. You sneak in with the phone, and we got to hear her singing one of the American Idol songs.
Okay, Andrea, are you ready?
Oh, I hear the water.
Yes.
Okay, start singing.
A moment like this, some people say like that, but a moment like this,
it's pretty good.
Some people say,
like, can you hear?
Yeah.
Okay.
Considering the hour.
Oh, I can't believe it's happening to me.
We need Simon.
Some people wait a lifetime for a moment like me.
All right, all right.
Is that enough?
Wow.
Is that enough?
More than enough.
Where's the hammer so I can hit Justin in the head?
You know, I think it wouldn't be American Idol if we didn't have Simon here to berate each of the callers.
Yeah.
Hey, what did I say? Sing the friggin' song. Okay? Sing it correctly.
Okay.
Hey, guys, what was that?
What?
Come on. If we're going to sing, let's sing. Don't half-ass it, okay?
Let's go. All right.
Tim and Willy in the morning.
Hello. I was wondering if I could request a song.
Please, sure. Please.
Please, I would like to hear Toby Keith's Beer for My Horses.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, we
I
might.
I never hear that song.
What?
We've even got a bus song version of that.
You do?
Oh, yeah.
Well, I need to hear it because I'm on my way to work and I've got the worst boss in the world. So.
Oh, you're kidding me.
Oh, no, I'm not.
Oh, well, that's too bad.
And she's terrible.
Oh, what's her problem?
I don't know. She's from another world.
You want to say your name on the radio and get yourself fired?
No, thank you.
All right. Well, good luck. We'll play you the song, okay?
Okay. Do you know when you're going to play it?
How about now?
Now would be perfect.
Okay.
All right.
See ya.
Bye.
How you like me now, y'all, baby?
O'clock news say somebody been shot, somebody been abused, somebody blew up a building, somebody stole a car, somebody got away, somebody didn't get too far, yeah, they didn't get too far.
You gonna do the Willy part?
My great-grandpappy told my pappy back in my day, son, that a man need to answer for the wicked that he done. If it took all the rope in Texas, tall oak tree, round up all of them bad boys, hang them high in the street for all the people to see.
That justice is the one thing you should always find. You gotta saddle up your boys, you gotta draw a hard line.
When the gun smoke settles, we'll sing a victory tune. We'll all meet back at the local saloon.
We'll raise up our glasses against evil forces, singing whiskey for my men, beer for my horses. We got too many gangsters doing dirty deeds.
Too much corruption and crime in the streets.
It's time the long arm of the law put a few more in the ground.
Send them all to the maker and he'll settle them down.
You can bet he'll settle them down. Cause justice is the one thing you should always find. You gotta saddle up your boys, you gotta draw a hard line.
When the gun smoke settles, we'll sing a victory tune and we'll all meet back at the local saloon.
We'll raise up our glasses against evil forces, singing whiskey for my men, beer for my horses. Singing whiskey for my men, beer for my horses.
What's your favorite radio station?
This is Tim and Willy in the morning, in the morning, in the morning, in the morning.
Got a lot of calls from people who didn't quite hear all of our Dan Rather, Saddam Hussein interview.
Mm-hmm.
Now, we're going to play it for you here in just a few minutes, but there are people still calling about it with reaction.
Hey, I just wanted to talk about that interview.
What'd you think?
All right.
Well, you know, I only caught the last 20 minutes, kind of bits and pieces of it, but it seemed to me like he was trying to, Dan Rather's trying to show him in a good light, and what was up with that?
Well, yeah, and there are people, first of all, the White House was furious because CBS would not allow them any time to rebut what Saddam Hussein was saying. And secondly, there's other people saying Saddam's asking Dan Rather, apparently, a lot of questions after the interview about what America really thinks and what are our intentions, and these people in Washington are saying, hey, you know, Dan Rather doesn't represent this country. He's a journalist. He's not a diplomat.
Yeah, no.
Well, he didn't even ask I mean, there was one part when he says, I would tell Americans if their country was being attacked, that they would need to stand up and fight and support their country. But isn't that what we're doing?
Hello, that's what's happening here.
God. Hello.
Hello.
We've given them enough warning. We've been telling them for 6 months. Here we come.
Hey, Saddam, where were you when the world stopped turning? Idiot.
No kidding. So did he even ask him about the connection with bin Laden? I mean, did that even come
up? Yeah, he did ask him about that. And what's his name? Saddam kind of denied having any connections, right?
He framed the question oddly. Dan Rather asked him, he said, are you worried that bin Laden is more popular with everyday Arabs than you? Isn't that odd?
That's an odd question, but I think maybe he's just trying to strike at his ego a little bit.
Yeah.
I guess. I don't know. I was kind of confused with the whole thing because seemed like they were more friends than interviewing one of our biggest enemies.
It kind of made me, it was hard to watch.
Well, you know that those two ended up going out afterwards to a Berkeley's bar.
See ya.
Tim and Willie in the morning.
Hi, just 1 minute. My 4-year-old son would like to speak to you.
Oh, he's lucky he can talk at 4.
Here you go, bud.
Hello.
Hello.
I'm
here, Tim and Willie. Check out me. Check out I will only money my think what and what and see. I want to talk about you, usually. Especially, talk about me.
Hey, somebody get some pants on that kid!
Thanks a lot.
Put them on.
See you later.
Bye-bye.
Nice job.
Bye.
Tim and Willie in the morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Hi, hi, hi.
How are you?
Good.
Okay, I'm not awake, so I thought I better play speed trivia to wake me up.
Okay. How many woods would a woodchuck chuck if a woodchuck could chuck wood?
Wait a second. I've got a few of the questions here.
Okay.
If you'd like to...
Go easy on me. I'm really tired.
Okay.
All right.
Who's love toy?
You just blew it.
What?
That's too long.
See, speed trivia, you don't have to be right. You just have to be fast.
All right, give her one more chance.
I can hear you.
Now we're ready. Here we go.
Are you ready?
Okay, I'm ready.
Is your shirt wrinkled?
Blue.
That's pretty slow. Try again.
Okay, where's Andrea?
Home.
You are not answering fast enough.
Okay,
you've got pauses in there that you could drive a truck through.
Okay, okay.
All right. Are you ready?
Yeah.
Is Jake a plumber?
Red.
You really don't get it, do you?
What?
You're not answering fast enough. Okay, here's another.
You know, I'm on a cell phone. There's always like a little pause in there.
Oh, that's true. All right.
And you're in Europe.
All right. Are you ready?
Yeah. I'm ready.
Have you seen Tim's hat trick?
Hey, you know what?
I'm ready.
Maybe you should quit while you're sucking.
Oh, no. Now, be nice.
Oh, come on, you guys. Cut me a break.
All right. What's today's date?
Mountain.
Who are you kidding?
Okay, you know what? I'm too slow at this game. I just can't
do
it.
Try again another day.
All right.
Okay, bye.
We love you. Bye.
Hey, what's your favorite radio station?
This is Tim and Willie in the morning, in the morning, in the morning.
So in an effort to come up with a catchy slogan that will live on weeks and months and years, maybe even after we're gone, just like the Elvis has left the building guy.
Sure.
I've got a top five list of potential phrases. These are things that have been uttered on our show that maybe we'll be remembered by.
All right.
All righty.
Are you ready?
Yes, yep. Please.
Here we go. Top five Tim and Willie phrases. Number five.
Big time, in line, on time, feeling fine, laying the best, spinning around, spinning those platters. That's all that matters. Tim and Willie in the morning. Ah!
What do you think?
Yeah.
Not bad.
Number four.
Speaking of the fair, we are expecting fair skies. Funny little tie-in there.
Yeah.
Is that you, Tim?
That was me.
On helium?
Back in the early days. Number three.
I am not the anthrax killer.
Yeah.
Thank you and good night. What do you think?
Yeah.
Number two.
Are you ready, Willie? I was born ready.
Come on, buddy.
Let's go. Let's do it.
And the number one potential legendary Tim and Willie phrase.
We suck. Come in and listen.
Thank you and good night.
Yeah.
Thank you and good night.
Yeah, good night, everybody.
We can book it. Take it to the bank.
Tim and Willie in the morning.
Okay, so we got to do a little work here for the listeners. Guy calls, wants us to get a hold of his wife to let her know that when she goes to her scheduled appointment this afternoon at the hair salon, he's already taken care of it because he loves her and he's just being a nice guy and he's also got some, he's got a facial ready for her. She doesn't know about that. But anyway,
he's
calling.
He's paid and tipped the whole 9 years.
On behalf of the salon to let her know she's going to get the royal treatment this afternoon. What a good guy.
Hello.
Yes, hello. Is JD there, please?
Speaking.
Hi, JD. This is Simone down at the Ulta salon. What's funny?
Any salon open at 6 a.m.
Yes, well, we come in very, very early, and we have an aerobics program, and we actually have a little coffee club. But anyway, I'm just calling because Jean-Pierre wanted to talk to you. You have an appointment with us today, is that right? Yes, okay.
Parlez-vous français?
He says hello. I'll translate because his English is not that good.
Okay.
Bon matin.
How are you?
Mademoiselle.
Missy.
I'm
fine. Good morning.
Je t'aime. Bon, c'est longtemps.
When you come for your appointment today,
je donne une condition au moins. Fais le macou.
You do not need to bring your purse or any money.
Café, s'il vous plaît, je peux consommer de la crème au tonction.
Would you like an espresso with a twist?
And a banana in the tailpipe.
You stop. You're just getting me excited now.
Joyeux de Bastille.
So the point is, don't bring your purse or any of your money today when you come to the salon.
Ça c'est tout. Faut les chiens coiffer tout le monde en snina.
Or any sausage.
And no bananas.
Right.
Okay.
You know why?
Why?
Because your husband, Troy, he came down here yesterday and he already paid for your appointment.
Ooh, Troy, pour ce nom de, que le magnifique.
Wow.
Did you know that? What?
No, I didn't.
He did it because he loved you and because he said you're just having a very, very hard day and a hard week.
Oh, that's so sweet.
Very hard. Yeah.
Is he getting me back for the hickey?
Yes, exactly.
This is payback for Mickey, I knew it.
So,
well, that was sweet.
So come on, and there's some other surprises when you get here too, okay?
Okay.
Jacques Cousteau, a French toast.
Jacques Cousteau? Holy crap, Jacques Cousteau and toast?
Have a good day then, girlfriend. We'll see you a little later.
Thank you.
All right.
Ta-ta.
And when you come in, be sure that they're listening to Tim and Willie.
All righty, thank you.
Au revoir.
Au revoir.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Hey, this is Tim and Willie in the morning.
And now our country western record show continues with Zeke Parker singing, My Hole Has a Bucket in It.
Tim and Willie in the morning.
Standing by now in the dome of country music stardom, Jeff the Janitor and Andrea. And hey, I know that good-looking lady. It's Terry Clark.
Hey, how's it going?
It's pretty going good.
How you doing?
I'm doing just fine, thank you very much. Got a little sinus infection going on today.
Really?
Yeah. Just to give you the inside scoop on country music and what's going on in Nashville.
Well, it is always cold and flu season when you are a country music singer. Isn't that true?
It really is. And, you know, I bet you half the people have it right now, too.
Oh, really?
It's going around.
Yeah, it is. There's been a lot of funk going around.
Hey, Terry.
Let's talk about something else, shall we?
Well, here's something I've always wondered, because different tour managers and backstage handlers say different things to, you know, fans and so forth, listeners that we bring back. Do you ever have a problem with people, like, jumping into your arms and licking you on the face?
That's how she got it.
You know, yeah, exactly. I don't have too many problems with people licking me on the face, but I do have some people who cry and stuff and get a little bit overzealous. And I never know quite what to say. Usually I turn it back on them and start crying myself.
Yeah. You should keep a little box of Kleenex, one of those little, you know, you just stuff it in your pocket and then hand them a hanky.
Exactly. And then somebody came up to me the other day and had my name tattooed on his arm.
Oh, wow.
In very large letters. And he said, "You know what? You're my biggest fan." So that's right, I am.
Interesting.
But hey, is it raining back there?
It's sprinkling a little bit.
Ah.
Yeah, kind of yucky. It's cold and rainy and cloudy and just perfect for coming and talking to radio stations. Perfect weather for that because you're inside.
Yeah. Absolutely.
Yes.
And how about the Mad Song? Is that just becoming a wildly popular hit for you?
It actually is. Thank you very much. Awesome. Thanks to you guys for playing
it,
too.
What did I tell you? It was my idea, wasn't it, Willy?
There's a lot of mad.
That one I'll give you. That one was your idea.
Yeah.
There are a lot of angry women out there, I've discovered.
Well, and since you did it for us that day in studio, you know, we do get a lot of calls from ladies who say, "Hey, I want my husband to hear that. Will you play that in 15 minutes? So, it's an appointment song.
You go out to the garage and listen and just wait, because I have a message for you.
Absolutely.
You know, if men would just be men, women wouldn't be so mad. Ain't that right?
I kind of get what you just said there.
Well, you know what?
We
can talk about that at length some other time.
Okay. Well, you know how it is. Men are from Mars. Women are from a vastly superior planet.
Yeah.
Aha. Uranus.
Hey, good morning. I was shooting for Neptune myself.
Nasty.
Are we going to see you on the show?
Yes, you will. I'll be presenting some kind of an award. I still don't know what it is.
What about singing? Are you going to sing any of those little segue dealies?
I don't think so. No, I did that years ago. I think I'm past that, but not quite to the point where I get a whole song yet.
Excellent.
Hey, do you have a favorite?
I'm at the gangly growing pain stage of my career.
Yeah.
In between.
But Terry, do you have a favorite new artist yourself that you're sort of keeping your eye on to see how they do?
Oh, I have a lot of favorite new artists. I really, you know, there's no big mystery. Keith Urban's doing really well, but I've been a fan of his for a couple of years now since he started making records.
You know, that kid can play the guitar, can't he?
Yes, he can. I taught him everything he knows. Ask him. Rap.
All right, Terry. Well, thanks for the time with us. Okay. You know, we'd love to keep talking to you, but I just want to be mad for a while.
Okay.
Ooh, segue.
Thank you, Terry.
Nice.
Brilliant.
Terry. There she is.
One, him. 3, 4. Last night we went to bed not talking. We'd already said too much. I faced the wall, you faced the window. Bound and determined not to touch. Been married 7 years now. Some days it feels like 21. I'm still mad at you this morning. Coffee's ready if you want some. I've been up since 5, thinking about me and you.
Hey, Terry.
Hey, hey.
Even before Willy started playing the cowbell, I love that song.
Well, thanks.
This is Tim and Willy in the Morning.
Hello.
Hi.
Hello.
Who this?
This is Tim and Willy.
Hey.
Yeah.
Here?
Yeah, go ahead.
Yeah, who did that? Do what diddy diddy dum diddy dum?
Do what diddy diddy dum diddy.
There she goes, just walking down the street singing.
I believe that was Eric Burdon and the Animals.
No way.
Oh, no, you know what, you know who it was?
Who?
No. It was Manfred Mann.
Manfred Mann.
Really?
Manfred Mann. It just came
Manfred
to
Mann,
me.
I thank you a lot.
There it is.
I want a lot of money. Appreciate it.
Good
Did
deal,
you really?
Buddy.
Boy, there's an example of just stuff that I got in my brain I wish I could get rid of. I mean, except for this guy helping him out. There's no need for me to remember that anymore.
You can get rid of it.
Yeah. I wish I could remember all my kids' names. I can't, but I can remember that Manfred Mann did the song Do Why Diddy.
Well, erase that one now that you don't need it anymore, and maybe something new will pop in.
All right, hey, buddy, do you want to go Double or Nothing on another song?
I don't know if you realize he's gone.
Oh.
Willie.
Tim and Willie in the Morning.
Hey. What, are you kidding me? We didn't forget you.
I know what you're thinking.
It's time here.
Wednesday website of the week.
But it's not Wednesday. Oh, it's
special Thursday edition.
Oh, I see you working now. All right. Yeah, we got a Wednesday website of the week here on Thursday.
Yes, we do.
That we'd like to tell you about. And, of course, in case you don't know, any Tim and Willie approved website must, first of all, be clean and fun for the whole family.
Yeah.
Or try to be, anyway.
Right.
And secondly, it's got to be something that helps you waste quality time.
Oh, that's always key.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
I mean, you got to make a minute seem like hours or vice versa.
Yep.
So here's the deal. We searched and searched and searched. I'm so excited about this website. I don't know why we never thought of this sooner. www.snoopy.com.
Snoopy.
And man, on Snoopy's website, there's just tons and tons of stuff to do. But man, my favorite is when you get to play baseball against Charlie Brown.
Really?
And it's tough. I've been playing it for 2 days. It's the first time I've beaten Charlie. And he wasn't that good, if I remember right, from the cartoon.
Not at football, because Lucy would always pull the ball out right before he kicked it.
Right.
Which would have been funny if they'd have done that to the guy at the Super Bowl over the weekend.
Oh, God.
Whoops, sorry.
Good grief. Hey, so I'm going to put the mic down here so you can hear on my little laptop computer what the baseball game sounds like.
Okay, here we go.
Okay, that's just the ball being thrown back to Charlie Brown after a pitch.
Good.
Hear that? Hear that? Okay.
Okay.
Here's what it sounds like with Snoopy swings. Listen. That's Snoopy swinging.
How many swings is he taking? It sounds like he's a Benihana chef.
Yeah, well, see, that's how I found out how you beat Charlie Brown. You got to. All right, there, it's over. Charlie Brown won. Okay, now hold on a second. I'm just going to. All right, fine. Yeah. All right, now I'm going to start. Come on.
Sounds here we go. Like one.
I'm going to start swinging. Step. There's the pitch. And I strike one. Wait. So there's the pitch. Boing! Yeah, just hit Charlie Brown and knocked him down. I tell you what, it's a blast.
So, who's pitching?
Charlie.
Charlie's
pitching.
Who's batting?
Snoopy. And you're Snoopy. You get to hit the clicker with.
Well, who couldn't strike out a dog? Unless, of course, it was Air Bud.
May you rest in peace. Yeah. But Snoopy, like I say, just after 2 days, I finally beat it once. That's www.snoopy.com.
I've been kissed by a dog.
Oh.
I have dog germs. Get hot water. Get some disinfectant. Get some iodine.
That is it, our
Wednesday website of the week. Special Thursday edition.
Tim and Willie in the morning.
All right, so we're calling Cindy. You got the little song ready?
Yeah.
Okay.
You're
gonna
love
it. Poor guy said, wants to wish his wife a happy birthday, but, you know, couldn't afford to pay attention. I mean, a nice gift.
Hello?
Hello, is this Cindy?
Yes.
Cindy, how are you? This is Tim and Willie.
Hello.
Hey, you know Bob, your husband?
Yeah, I know him.
Okay, of course you know him. he, you know, was, he hired us. He spent all of his money to have us write a song just for you for your birthday.
Cool.
A custom-made birthday song.
Yep.
Oh, that's cool.
Now, he could have gotten you some jewelry or taken you out for a nice meal or probably anything, but he said this will be special and unique.
Okay.
All right. Are you ready for your song, Cindy?
Yes, I am.
All right. Here we go. Hit it, Willie.
I'm not a bum. I really work, but it's been strapped with money, kind of.
I was wondering if you guys can help me out with a birthday and just maybe sing happy birthday. I feel so bad I can't get her nothing.
Happy birthday, Cindy, baby. I feel so bad I can't get her nothing, no, no, nothing. I'm such a loser, I got no money. I can't get my baby nothing for her birthday. So all I can do is give her this song from Tim and Willie.
Cindy, what'd you think of that?
You guys are awesome.
Wow.
Hey, that was $5,000 well spent, wasn't it?
Yeah, it really
it
was.
It sure was.
It was the happy birthday, feel so bad I can't get her nothing blues.
Oh, he gives me stuff every day of the year, so we're perfect.
Geez, shut up.
I'm serious.
Oh, that's a beautiful thing. All right, well, happy birthday.
Thank you.
Yes, yes. This is
Tim and Willie in the morning.
Yes.
It's Tim and Willie in the morning.
Great idea.
Yes.
Okay, why am I talking to two people?
Well, because you've called Tim and Willie.
Oh, lovely.
Hey, don't start with that attitude.
I've never talked to Tim and Willie. I know we're calling the radio store shows.
Have you ever called
you
a radio?
Terrible. I listen to you guys all the time. You guys are terrible.
Have you ever called a Radio Shack?
No, I've never called a Radio Shack either.
So what do you do for a living?
I work at a truck wash.
No kidding. What's it cost to get your truck washed these days?
$34.99 if you're just getting a tractor wash.
Hmm. Does that include that's just the tractor, but not the...
Not the trailer.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. And do you have that new tractor smell?
Sure. It's called Learn How to Take a Shower.
And you say we're terrible.
Well.
Uh-huh. What's your name?
Joyce,
it's been a joy to talk to you.
Well, Joyce, I think we've talked to you before, haven't we?
No, I've never talked to you guys before.
Yes. Oh, you call every week.
And I don't think I'm going to call again because you guys are embarrassing me.
Oh, come on. You think you're embarrassed? You should see us.
Yeah, all right. You're Tim and Willie. You guys don't get embarrassed.
It's humiliating to get up and do this show every day. You have no idea.
Mm-hmm. Try being a truck wash attendant.
Hey, we'll switch with you one of these days.
Yeah, that's
okay,
right.
That would be great.
We'd like to know what it's like to actually work for a living.
You think? Okay.
Joyce.
Been there, done that, actually.
See you later.
All right, thanks.
See ya.
Hey, this is Tim and Willie in the morning.
Do you have any advice for people trying to quit smoking just for the day?
Just for today?
Yep.
Oh, yeah, just don't smoke for today.
Baby steps.
That's right, baby steps. You know what? Just like anything else, any other habit you're trying to break, one day at a time.
Are you gonna quit smoking today?
That is exactly right, my friend.
Yay.
And this time, it's gonna work for good.
All right.
I promise myself that.
Okay. You know who I heard just quit smoking?
Who?
That woman they electrocuted last week.
What was her name?
Oh, my God.
Okay. Betsy and Hatchet, Molly Hatcher. Molly.
Something like that.
Oh.
Good luck. We're right behind you all the way. Tim and Willie.
I've only been smoking now for just the last few years. The reason that I started, because I gave up drinking beers. Now I'm done. Yeah, done. As soon as I finish my last pack, I'll get rid of this wheezing hack. Baby, I'm done. Baby, I believe I gotta quit this smoking. I cough a lot and I've been choking. Oh, Winston-Salem, even Marlboro. Virginia Slims, you know they're for girls. Gonna give it a good try, cause I wanna just stay alive. Baby, I'm done. Oh, yeah. Oh. Take it, Barb. Hey, it's all yours, Jimmy. Baby, I believe I gotta quit this smoking. I cough a lot and I keep choking. Oh, Lucky Strike and Bel Air Menthols. Benson Hedges, man, they're real tall. I'm gonna give it a good try, cause I wanna just stay alive. Baby, I'm done.
You know, smoking ain't no fun. If you want to have clean lungs, baby, I'm done. Oh, God. Man, I'm done. Yeah, done. Woo! Take it, Roy. Yeah, I'm done. Yeah, I'm done.
Come on. Bye-bye.
Tim and Willy in the morning.
Hi, Toby Keith here. Spank it, crank it, smack it on a bing bong.
Yeah, that's right. That's the real Toby. Remember yesterday we had the guy call, says he wants us to wake his sister up?
Oh, yeah.
Jenny. He wants us to do the Toby Keith wake up, which is just me doing a very bad impersonation of Toby.
Oh, not
bad.
It's good.
Pretty good.
All right, we're ringing her up. She's 19 today? Yeah, I think so.
On the phone, you really got to sound like him. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Hello?
Hey, how you doing? Is this Jenny?
Yeah.
Jenny, how's it going? It's Toby Keith.
Hi.
Hey, I hear it's your birthday today.
Yeah, it is.
Yeah, well, they got a hold of me at my fan club, and they told me to give y'all a call. Wish you a happy birthday.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah, what are you, like, 19 today?
Yeah.
All right. I understand you're a big fan of my music. Is that true?
Oh, totally. Yeah.
Yeah, well. we really appreciate it. Please tell me you already bought a copy of my new CD, Unleashed.
I don't think I have that yet.
Oh, my. Well, what's your favorite song by me? Maybe I'll sing you a little bit right now.
My favorite song, I Want to Talk About Me.
I like that one. Come on.
Okay.
Talk about your grandma down in Alabama. I like that part. I like it. I want to talk about me, want to talk about I, want to talk about number one on my, what I think, what I like, what I know, what I want, what I do. I'm just talking about you usually. But occasionally, I want to talk about me.
Me.
But anyway, enough about me. What do you think of me?
What do I think of you?
Yeah, how do you like me now, baby?
I think you're a really great singer. Yeah. I like you a lot.
Yeah. Hey, who's your daddy?
Who's my daddy?
Yeah.
His name's Alex.
How do you think he'd like to have a boot in his ass?
I don't think he'd like that very much.
All right. Hey, next time you get the chance, would you say hi to a couple of good friends of mine?
Sure.
Tim and Willie in the morning.
Okay.
They're a couple of disc jockeys.
All right.
And they're in the new People Magazine Sexiest Men Alive issue.
All right. Okay.
Well, Jenny, you have a good birthday today, and thanks for being a Toby Keith fan, all right?
Well, thank you.
All right.
Okay.
So you should have been a cowboy. Get you some.
All right.
Bye.
Tim and Willie in the morning.
Hey, we got somebody on the phone who wants to hear a little fishing song, waking up with Tim and Willie this morning.
Yeah, I'm trying to wake up with Tim and Willie.
Hey, what's your name?
Big Doug.
Big Doug?
Yeah.
All right, Big Doug.
Hey, Big Doug, you going fishing?
I hope so.
Well, if you can't go fishing, at least play a song about fishing.
Yeah.
It's the next best thing.
Sounds good.
All right.
And then flip on the sports channel and watch a little fishing.
Yeah.
I like it.
Thank you.
See you later. That reminds me of... our buddy Brian Regan.
Oh yeah,
I'm like a TV guy myself. I was watching Fishing today on TV. That makes you worry about yourself. You know, you ever watch Fishing for like 15 minutes and then just go, boy, I better get a life. I'm watching Fishing. I'm not even fishing. I'm watching Fishing. I'm too lazy to fish. I'm taping Fishing to watch again later. Hey, come on over. I got a fishing tape. No, a new one. You know what's amazing about those? At the end, they roll credits. You know, there's like 90 people involved with the two guys fishing. And one of the credits is film editor. This poor guy, he has to watch all the footage. It's not exciting enough to make it into that final show. He's got to sit there all day going, no, 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 no. Mm-mm. And one of the credits is writer. There's a writer for the fishing show. Well, what's he writing? Ooh, she's a beauty. You know, guy typing it out on the typewriter. Yeah, here's your script, you know. You work on that. We're filming tomorrow, you know. Okay, you got a fish. You got a line. It's a fish and it's a beauty fish. It's a fish and a beauty. Fish is a beauty. Okay, cut. You okay, man? You need a drink of water?
Brian Regan on fishing shows. Let's all watch one today, shall we?
Yes.
Hey, what's your favorite radio station?
This is Tim and Willie in the morning, in the morning, in the morning.
All right, wait. Before you go, we've got five questions for you. We got time? Yes, we do.
Yes, hit me with the hard question.
Okay, David Alan Greer, name one thing that might tick off Bonnie Hunt.
Me naked.
Hey, that leads to question two. Have you ever seen Jim Carrey naked?
Yes, mostly.
Mostly naked?
Yes, I would.
Okay. If you could start your career over as a professional athlete, what would be your sport and why?
Oh, let me see. Professional athlete. I would say basketball, because that's the sport I love to watch the most. I love boxing, but nobody wants to be an old fighter. Basketball.
Next question. What's the weather like in Chicago today?
The weather in Chicago is a balmy 85 degrees.
And question number five for Dag, David Alan Greer.
Daggeroni, hit me hard.
What's the craziest prank pulled so far on the set of The Bonnie Hunt Show?
One time the guys told me that my call time was 8 o'clock in the morning, and I showed up about 45 minutes late, and I tried to make it like it was a prank, but I was really late, so it wasn't.
That's crazy, man. That's absolutely upside down.
Yeah, it's crazy.
David, thanks for spending a few minutes with us.
Anytime, Benny, Philly, love you.
We love you. You're one of the best guests we've ever had on this show.
Hey, thank you. And guys, remember, there is an order of protection. Don't you ever approach me.
Yeah. I'm sorry.
We've learned our lesson.
We respect you.
Okay.
See you, David.
Later.
Tim and Willie in the morning.
Bye. See you later.
Oh, I'm glad I just remembered this. My daughter has a little friend at school, and her dad is having a birthday today, and they requested, my daughter's little friend, Maddie, got a hold of me and said, would you please wake up my daddy with that angry neighbor guy? Remember that?
Yeah.
Jim Brewer, an actual live wake-up we did with him in studio one morning. So I got to call my buddy Joe and see if we can catch him off guard this morning.
Never expect it.
Not at this hour. He's supposedly in the shower still, so we're catching him when, you know, naked and squeaky clean.
Hello?
Hello?
Is there an echo in here?
Yeah, listen here, you knucklehead. I work for a living, you understand? And I need you to get up.
Get up? Why?
You got your dog out there, and he poops on my lawn one more time. I'm going to bust you into snot bugs. What, you plan on sleeping your whole life?
Well, I was.
I'm sick and tired. You understand? I pay taxes. This is America.
I pay taxes too, buddy.
Get up!
Is this that Tim and Billy show?
First of all, I need you to start wearing some clothes. If your dog poops on the lawn one more time...
I can't help that.
I need you to get up, hotshot. What are you doing?
I'm getting up now.
Okay. Hey, Joe, how you doing?
Good, Tim.
How'd you know it was us?
Yeah. Oh,
gee.
We were told you'd be in the shower right now.
And since we had that camera installed, we figured, what the heck?
It's a little foggy. If you could just squeegee the lens, that'd be...
Well, I dropped it. I'm sorry.
All right. Anyway, happy birthday, man.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Yeah, I think we ought to sing this to him now. Is everybody ready?
Yeah.
Here we go.
Let's do a quick one real quick. Ready?
Yeah.
Happy birthday to you.
Yeah.
Happy to you. Happy dear. Happy birthday to you.
All right. Happy birthday, Joe.
Thank you, Tim.
And one more thing.
Yes.
Get up! Yes. This
is Tim and Willy in the morning.
Yes.
It's Tim and Willy in the morning.
Great idea.
Yes.
Oh, I'm glad I just remembered this. My daughter has a little friend at school, and her dad is having a birthday today, and they requested, my daughter's little friend, Maddie, got a hold of me and said, would you please wake up my daddy with that angry neighbor guy? Remember that?
Yeah.
Jim Brewer, an actual live wake-up we did with him in studio one morning. So I got to call my buddy Joe and see if we can catch him off guard this morning.
Never expect it.
Not at this hour. He's supposedly in the shower still, so we're catching him when, you know, naked and squeaky clean.
Hello?
You're
an echo in here?
Yeah, listen here, you knucklehead. I work for a living, you understand? And I need you to get up.
Get up? Why?
You got your dog out there, and he poops on my lawn one more time. I'm going to bust you into snot bugs. What, you plan on sleeping your whole life?
Well, I was.
I'm sick and tired. You understand? I pay taxes. This is America.
I pay taxes too, buddy.
Get up!
Is this that Tim and Billy show?
First of all, I need you to start wearing some clothes. If your dog poops on the lawn one more time...
I can't help that.
I need you to get up, hotshot. What are you doing?
I'm getting up now.
Okay. Hey, Joe, how you doing?
Good, Tim.
How'd you know it was us?
Yeah. Oh,
gee.
We were told you'd be in the shower right now.
And since we had that camera installed, we figured, what the heck?
It's a little foggy. If you could just squeegee the lens, that'd be...
Well, I dropped it. I'm sorry.
All right. Anyway, happy birthday, man.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Yeah, I think we ought to sing this to him now. Is everybody ready?
Yeah.
Here we go.
Let's do a quick one real quick. Ready?
Yeah.
Happy birthday to you.
Yeah.
Happy to you. Happy dear. Happy birthday to to you.
All right, happy birthday, Joe.
Thank you, Tim.
And one more thing.
Yes.
Get up.
Yes. This is Tim and Willy in the morning.
Yes.
It's Tim and Willy in the morning.
Great idea.
Yes.
Now, Willy, this is our first show we've done since Christmas time, and usually this is where we start showing off some of the gifts we got.
Yeah.
One of them, you got two musical gifts.
Yes, I did.
One is spectacular from your wife.
Yeah.
But we'll talk about that in a little while.
This was pretty spectacular too, dude.
I got you one, and normally I always get you a combination Christmas birthday present because your birthday is a couple of days before.
Yeah.
Before, it's like the 22nd, right?
22nd.
Before Christmas.
Yeah. So I usually get like a gift that covers both. And this is a nice one.
Yeah.
I got no complaints.
Describe what it is.
Tim, this is the Yamaha DD55, which is a digital percussion instrument.
Right on.
Stereo sampled drum pad. So basically it's an electronic drum kit for the studio. So just more goofing around for me while we're on the air.
Right on.
Dude. All right, I don't know if you can... I'm going to put the mic down to the speaker. Hold on.
All right. We'll get that thing mic'd up. Always takes the longest to mic the drums.
All right, I got to turn it all the way up. This doesn't go to 11. It only goes to 9. Crash cymbal. It's got a nice jazz ride, man. Check it out.
I wouldn't have known that. The guy at Sharper Image didn't know that. But I knew you'd know it.
You ready?
Yeah. It's Christmas morning all over again.
I am the new drummer for the All Earl Band.
All right, ladies and gentlemen. Hey, Willy!
What? I can't hear you!
Buddy! on. What?
Will you two shut up? People are trying to sleep.
Woo!
Yeah.
When you think it's funny, but it's not. Tim and Willy in the morning.
Okay.
Yep.
If you were listening yesterday, you heard the special Thursday edition of the Wednesday website of the week, and it was so bad. I can't believe
it was pathetic
that we did not get reprimanded for such bad radio information.
What was it again? I've already even forgotten.
Nah, don't even want to attempt to go there.
But so today we're going to bring you for the first time ever the
Wednesday website of the week. Unprecedented Friday edition.
The Unprecedented Friday edition of the Wednesday website of the week.
Man, now this, after yesterday, this is going to be a refreshing time waster. We have a skeet shoot. It's the Christina Aguilera skeet shoot.
That's what I'm talking
where
about.
Where pictures of Christina Aguilera come flying out of one of those little huts where they, you know, like they fire those clay discs when the guys actually go skeet shooting. And you get to take shots at Christina Aguilera as she flies through the air. And it is just some good, clean fun. And here's what it sounds like, if you can hear it, on my little laptop here.
All right.
Are you ready?
Yep. Yeah.
Okay. That's about all it is. It's just little gunshots, but she when she you hit her.
Is she clothed?
Huh? Oh, she's clothed, yeah.
Well, that's unusual.
This is more like a high school photograph right out of a yearbook or something.
Oh,
so
that's back when she was sort of clean cut. Now she's one of my daughters kind of likes her, but man, she's really kind of
A hoochie slutty. Mama.
She's become a hoochie mama. That's
Don't they all start, Brittany? I mean, they all start that way, right? They're just clean cut kids singing clean cut music, then they turn into whores.
Hey, wait a minute.
I'm sorry.
What's it? Is it going to be on timandwilly.com?
It will be at timandwilly.com. It's your Christina Aguilera skeet shoot.
Wednesday website of the week. Unprecedented Friday edition.
Hey, how you doing this morning?
We're doing great, man.
Hey, I was wondering, what's Willy going to, are you all going to come up with this great tune for your Dateline or whatever, you know? Why don't you come up with something like that, you know, that where they go on the computer or whatever looking for somebody?
Yeah,
that's a great idea.
You guys are great at putting out these nice little songs, you know? I love your ditties. They're
you know,
great.
If we could do a song about dating on the internet, what would that sound like, Willy?
I will never forget the place where we first met. You were the prettiest girl in the room, at least that's what you said. On the internet, the things you typed were oh so swell. I fell in love with you, even though you couldn't spell. On the internet, 2,000 miles apart. On the internet, I downloaded your heart. On the internet, we were filled with desire. On the internet, my mouth was on fire. On the internet. Well, we decided that we should meet in person, for goodness sake, because we knew that the photos that we had sent were fakes. Oh, when laid eyes on me, you said you liked my big buck teeth, and I was taken in by your many lovely chins. On the internet, no one can see your thighs. On the internet, or your goofy crossed eyes. On the internet, you can't see pimply skin. On the internet, just the beauty within. On the internet.
Tim and Willy in the morning.
All right, we have a joke that somebody sent us, and you know we try to keep our standards up here on this program.
Yes, we've upped our standards.
So you know, up yours. But the lot of children listening, and so oftentimes there are jokes out there that are funny, but they're also a little dirty. So we feed them through the Joke Scrubber 5000, and it makes them just as funny, but not as dirty.
Right.
Cleans them up. It's a feature. We've got one here. We got to feed it in.
Tim and Willie clean up a dirty joke.
Okay, let's just got to fire this thing up. We haven't used it in a while. Sounds like it's flooded. Okay, Willie, you're just piping the joke in there. There, mm-hmm. You hear the scrubbing bubble action.
Yeah.
Cleaning it up, making it pristine.
Works
suitable
really well.
For church.
Yeah.
And looks like it's coming out the other side. Oh. Here we go.
Squeaky.
Here we go now.
Tim and Willie clean up a dirty joke.
Okay.
All right. A guy decides it's time he got married. He gives each of his current girlfriends $1,000. One spends $200 on clothes and puts $800 in the bank. The second one spends $800 on clothes and puts $200 in the bank. The third puts the whole $1,000 in the bank. Which one did he marry?
Gee, I don't know.
Well, the one with the big chest.
Oh, he's a
hey,
jerk.
Hey!
You know, you can clean it up, but you can't keep it from being rude.
It's Tim and Willie in the morning.
Good morning.
Now, Willie, did you say you've made a song up about the blue ice falling from the airliner?
Yeah. I got something I threw down here real quick.
Can we hear it?
Like to hear it go.
Blue ice keeps falling on my head. My wife and I were mattress dancing when it hit my head. Something smells like poo.
Oh.
Ooh. Blue ice keeps falling from the sky through my ceiling and lands on me. Something reeks just like pee.
If you love that, you will love our Wednesday website of the week, which is coming up.
Yes, that's right.
No, you're listening to Tim and Willie in the morning.
You want to beat yourself to a pulp.
Uh-uh. Oh, by the way, we have a little bit of the SUV controversy update. Oh. Now, earlier in the week, you know, the story came out about the TV ads. I haven't seen one yet. About how if you drive an SUV, you're supporting terrorism because they guzzle gas and that's oil and et cetera. I think this is the most ridiculous thing. I haven't heard anybody who says they're for it, except we did find out who was putting those ads together.
Yeah.
And you saw that in the paper, right,
Norman
Andrew?
Norman Lear's. Norman Lear. He's the TV producer.
Yeah, he was all in the family.
Tons of Maude, all those shows. Yeah. Good times.
Well, it's this company called Environmental Media Association that he's the head of, and he is the one producing these. So they're really, I've seen one of the commercials. They're very well done. It's just very frustrating to see. Mm-hmm. Well, the controversy now is that apparently SUVs are only bad when you drive them because they've caught some celebrities like Gwyneth Paltrow, who appears in the ads. She drives a Mercedes-Benz SUV.
Right.
So she's basically,
hypocrite.
Yeah. Okay. Another EMA supporter, Chevy Chase, also drives an SUV.
Really?
But says they only use it when they have to attach the horse trailer or when they're carrying a lot of kids. That's
same
what his
here.
Representative says, right?
I got my kids in a horse trailer.
Barbara Streisand is out there, you know, telling people how to live their life, and that included with this whole controversy. And Streisand and her hubby, James Brolin, both have SUVs.
Nice.
And to top it off, Lear himself, the producer behind all of this, built a garage for 21 cars just 5 years ago.
Nice. Mm. Yeah, that doesn't waste too much oil. 21 what? Cars. You need all that.
Yeah, way to go there, Mr. Double Standard.
Yeah.
Shut the hell up.
Go back to England.
In the morning.
Bunch of jive mothers.
Woo! He said he wants a jingle that's longer than usual, so here's a longer jingle for Todd Glass with Tim and Willie in the morning.
Wait, when did you make that?
It's a little bit longer than usual.
But are we on the air?
Yeah.
I just said to you when I came in, I hope my jingle better be longer than usual, but you made that before or after I said that?
We psychically looked at
each other. I can't tell you because then I'll have to kill you.
Well, there's no way that you would have coincidentally made that jingle. Play that again. I love that.
He's Todd Glass.
He said he wants a jingle that's longer than usual, so here's a longer jingle for Todd Glass with Tim and Willie in the morning.
Hey.
Okay, I wanted to say this real quick. You came in here one time, one of the many visits you've had with us, where you told this thing. You said, I have this random bit in my head that I don't know where to put this, but guys at a gas station and they're filling up their car and then all of a sudden they start playing in slow motion like they're playing with a hose and they're like,
okay,
squirting the gas all over.
No, here's what happened. And by the way, I was kidding about him being a jerk. The long story is, yeah, I had this short that I had. It was about me being in a coma and I wanted to do it at a little theater in L.A. and it was basically a sketch show. So people come by to visit me in my coma. They tell stories And all those stories are pre-shot, obviously, because the night of the show, I just lay in a coma.
Right.
People go, I remember me and Todd used to play Little League together. And, of course, it goes to a flashback of when I was in Little League. And I had seen Ben Stiller at the Aspen Comedy Festival, and I asked him if he would do this, and he did it. And then there's a scene where we pull into the gas station, we squirt gas all over each other, you know, to music. You know, we're having such a good time. I hit my friend with gas. He hits me with gas. Next thing you know, gas is flying everywhere.
It's like a garden hose fight.
Right. Yeah. And it was exactly only at the gas station.
At the gas station.
You know, it's funny. You explained that a lot quicker. So anyway, in the show that I did 3 years ago, there's that scene. And then I go see Zoolander. And, well, I got like a million calls. They're like, oh, my God, that scene is in Zoolander. And coincidences happen. I'll end the story in 20 seconds. I know it's probably boring.
19.
Coincidences happen sometimes, but it was very odd, especially that Ben had done mine. 15. But I did call him. He was very cool. He said, first I wasn't going to call him. I don't know him, you know. So I was like, he did me a favor. What am I going to do? But I figured to call him. Maybe he doesn't know. And I really believe he didn't. I believe somebody else probably saw it. When you write a movie, people help you. Sure. Even if you have other people writing it, friends of theirs do it on the...
Your brother, it turns out, sold you out.
Yeah, right. And speaking of my brother, my stepbrother just became a... Anyway, there's the end of that story. And my brother, I was just home to visit. My brother, I have a stepbrother. Didn't we talk about that the last time I was here?
I don't remember.
He's like 21 now. And all he does is what if everything. Like, I was just home, and everything's like what if, and then he'll make up some ridiculous scenario. And then the would you rathers. Like, he's, would you rather poop out a bowling ball or pee out a marble? Would you rather have Tic Tacs for lips or Chewy Sprees for hair? Would you rather sit on a warm toilet seat at home or a cold toilet seat at the mall bathroom? Ooh. Or the other way around. I messed that up. Would you rather, you know these questions, and you're always, like, giving you a headache because you're trying to think of the, would you rather have poop for hair or sweat poop? I don't know, Stephen. Please stop. I can't. It's never going to happen. You know, there's scenario. And then, would you eat cat? Everything involves the poop word.
Yeah,
you know?
Yeah, he's a boy.
He doesn't use poop, the word. He uses the other word. I'm cleaning it up. Would you eat cat poop for $1 million? You know that thing all guys do? For $1 million. I'm like, no, Steve. And he goes, 10 million tax-free. I'm like, I don't. Yeah, I would. Shut up. You know? And let me tell you something. Get the money up front when you eat cat poop. I'll tell you that right now. He's paying me out in $20 installments.
Who is this guy?
It's another jingle that's even longer than the last one. Here's Funny Man Todd Glass on the radio with Tim and Willie in the morning, and Andrew and Jeff the janitor too.
Yeah. I love that.
Thanks, Todd.
Yay.
Good man, Todd Glass.
Every time I release some of the odor, Tim and Willie in the morning eliminates them.
All right, listener called, wanted to hear this from our past, from our archives. It's so bizarre, I'm not even sure if we explained it, it would make any more sense.
No, it wouldn't.
Just going to play it. It's called Elaine Wants to Be a Cow.
Well, I'm in my usual bad mood after listening to your program.
You are?
Yep. That cow thing that you played, I want to be a cow, I want to be a cow. I just makes me sick to my stomach.
The cow says...
Living in Green Valley, she doesn't like us. She's in her usual bad mood after listening to this program.
Makes me sick to my stomach.
She don't dip snuff.
Do you dip snuff?
What did you say?
Or smoke or drink.
Are you out of your mind?
Well, I could be.
Well, it looks like we're just going to be reported.
It might not go anyplace. You're just going to be reported.
Tell him why.
I want to be a cow. You can scratch my udders or something. I want to be a cow. It makes me sick to my stomach. I want to be a cow. I put up with this every time my grandson comes over here. I put up with your program. I took it as a personal insult when that cell had the audacity to ask me if I was smoking or sniffing snuff or something like that.
I know.
And another thing, I wouldn't play golf with him. I don't give a damn if he was Arnold Palmer. I'm not a complainer. If I don't want to listen to a program, I turn it off.
Right.
That's my prerogative.
Right.
And I don't go around complaining.
You've heard probably enough of our show to know that we're pretty like.
I hear your show. I've been hearing your show for 2 years. And that reflection about Green Valley, the people in Green Valley are not all golfers. They're not all drinkers. And I know they don't sniff snuff. I want to be a cow. You can scratch my udders or something. I want to be a cow. I don't go around complaining. I want to be a cow. I want to be a cow. I want to be a cow. I want to be a cow.
Would you say love your show? Did you say Tim and Willie love your show?
Are you out of your mind?
I don't know why, but I love that. Oh, my gosh.
Tim and Willie in the morning.
Oh, this is the guy we were talking about yesterday. We didn't have time for the story. The teenager from Blue Springs, Missouri, Joe Thompson, 18 years old, driving along in his Jeep, right?
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah. He got flung out of it or something?
He somehow or other got in a crash and was thrown from the Jeep and managed to grab onto utility wires hanging above him. He stayed there for over 20 minutes until he was rescued, and he was like 25 feet in the air hanging onto these utility wires.
How about that?
How did that happen? And then I heard that he called us on his dad on his cell phone during that time.
Yeah, that's how he let people know where he was. He was hanging by his hands from these utility wires, and then he reached down and grabbed his cell phone and made the call.
That's like only something that would happen in a movie.
Speaking of your last or your next action hero, I say we declare him the winner and save ourselves having to watch another reality show.
God, no kidding.
But aren't electrical wires, I mean, isn't that hazardous to touch those? Don't you get electrocuted?
I think if there's a lot of juice going through them, I think you need to either touch the ground or something. I'm not sure how that works.
How lucky are you that when you get thrown from a Jeep, there just happens to be some electrical wires to grab onto?
Yeah.
That's lucky.
All right, so keep that in mind.
Timing is everything.
If you're late this morning and you're driving really, really badly, look for something like electrical wires to grab onto.
Near the power line.
I don't know.
Yeah. Tim and Willie in the morning.
Well, look at us. Nice and early. We've got it for you.
Wednesday website of the week.
Unprecedented that we would be so together we could give you the Wednesday website of the week this early on a Wednesday. I'm proud of us.
I got to tell you something. This thing is a complete and total time waster and it is so addictive, but yet so family friendly and safe. And we're going to put it up, put a link to timandwilly.com here. And it's a miniature golf game.
Oh yeah!
And I gotta tell you something. I mean, it's got a windmill or two, and the clown's mouth and all that stuff. And it's kind of hard. I mean, because you actually have to be able to figure out how far to bring the putter back and line it up correctly. I sat one night and played it for about 2.5 hours, trying to lower my score each time, trying. But there's always one or two holes in the whole thing that'll throw it off for you. But I guarantee you, if you look this up at work, this has a cautionary disclaimer. Be careful. This could get you fired because you will start on it and you will not want to stop. It's like eating popcorn.
So it's a virtual online, what we would call goofy golf, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, a little putt-putt course.
I've never heard it called that.
Yeah.
Oh, really?
Miniature golf or putt-putt. Yeah. We called it putt-putt.
Putt-putt, goofy golf. Maybe it's because where I grew up, there was a place called Goofy Golf, and that was it. Or Goonie Golf for some reason. That was another.
Goonie Golf?
And then, but now.
Gremlin Golf.
Is there a virtual online, like, really bad pizza that you can order also? And virtual online, really expensive pitcher of Pepsi for your kids? Check it out. It'll be on a link at timandwilly.com hour.
Wednesday website of the week.
Oh, my gosh.
Yeah.
Look at what they're doing to people in Fairport Harbor, Ohio.
What?
A man and a woman who vandalized a baby Jesus statue in a church's outdoor nativity had to march through town with a donkey to apologize.
Oh, man, that's perfect.
Now, you talk about your make the punishment fit the crime, your reality discipline, your get real attitude.
Dr. Phil would love that.
Jessica Lange. Hey, wait, isn't she a famous actress?
Yes, she is.
And Brian Patrick?
Well, I don't know about him.
Weird.
I think he's a weekend disc jockey. Anyway, they're both 19. They were ordered by the judge to make Sunday's march through the northeast Ohio town after they admitted defacing a statue of St. Anthony Roman Catholic Church on Christmas Eve. Small groups of residents watched as the two walked and asked forgiveness. They led the donkey, provided by a petting zoo, through the streets carrying a sign that said, "Sorry for the jackass offense."
No way. Come on.
It's right here from the Associated Press.
That is awesome, dude.
The procession allowed Lane and Patrick to avoid a longer jail sentence for stabbing the statue and defacing it with satanic symbols.
Ew!
That's horrible. Anyway, this is kind of a conscience flogging, said municipal judge Michael Cicinetti. After the 30-minute march, the pair were taken by police to jail to serve a 45-day sentence that will include drug and alcohol treatment. They also must replace the statue.
Oh, wow.
Good for them. Good for that town, man. I love it.
All right. We'll keep you posted on this. Is a town that, you know, I want to. That would be a good show, a good cop show, where they make the penalty fit the crime.
Yeah, no kidding.
Get me my donkey.
Tim and Willy in the morning.
We shall not hesitate to spank the unruly ones.
Well, it's time for a Tim and Willy Britney Spears update.
Yeah. Because you do that a lot.
Now you're saying, whoa, wait a minute, what happened? Did you guys switch formats? Why are you talking about the queen of pop music right now? No, we didn't.
She's in the news.
I don't know. It just seems like she's everywhere. She's omnipresent. She's in the new Austin Powers movie. She's in every soda ad TV commercial that's on. She's on the cover of every magazine right now. I've got kids. My daughters are not into Britney at all. My son kind of, nah, he isn't either.
No, he's not.
In fact, my son got as a birthday present when he was like, eight, I don't know, a couple years ago, somebody gave him a Britney Spears poster, and he immediately trashed it, and I think it hurt the feelings of the other.
In front of the kid who gave it to him?
The other kid. He thought the kid was giving it to him to be funny, but he wasn't. Anyway, but chances are you have a kid that maybe is into Britney Spears, and so we give you this Britney Spears update. Now, a couple of stories. First of all, she was on a tour in Mexico, and she was being chased by the paparazzi, right? The photographers. And she flipped one of them off. Now, now Britney Spears, her appeal is to young, mostly girls. And that's not the kind of thing, you know, you want her teaching your young girls, certainly.
Right.
Right?
Britney, you're a role model.
And she,
that was said to be damage control more than anything. She flipped people off, and then they kind of slated it as, well, it was the press because they were chasing
it. It was the paparazzis. Well, here's when you're in the public eye like that, especially, you know, not that the paparazzi are really the nicest people in the world, but, you know, if you're going to flip somebody off, don't flip off somebody with a camera.
What were you thinking?
That's pretty dumb.
Wait till they run out of film or something, and then, anyway.
Well, that's part of the controversy. This happened in Mexico City, which was the final stop on her world tour. She's been on this tour for a while. Well, that Sunday evening, this past Sunday, she did her final concert of the entire tour. This was the finale. Guess how she ended it?
How?
During the fifth song. It was only the middle of the fifth song of the show. She suddenly stopped, and she said, I'm sorry, Mexico. I love you. Bye. That's it. Over. And they booed.
Amamos mucho, Mexico.
Like, what's up?
Adios.
Hey.
She's cracking.
Good night, Mexico. I love you. Bye-bye. Man, I wish
Mexico.
I could do that.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Oh, why is my mic just scratching like that?
Oh, yeah. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye, then. Goodbye, North America.
Bye-bye.
Thank you. Hey, Brittany, we're just checking the 15-minute clock.
1 minute. 1 minute remaining.
All right. This has been a Tim and Willy Britney Spears update.
Tim and Willy in the morning.
All right, Willie, this one email in particular was really bizarro. I thought it deserved its own attention.
Mm-hmm.
Tim and Willie, frozen stuff. With all this talk about frozen people, I was reminded of the hummingbird my husband brought home to me last fall. It was dead when he found it, laying on the ground, but it was beautiful, with a purple head and a bright green body. And he knows how much I love hummingbirds. So he put it in a clear plastic cassette case and brought it to me, which, if you think of it,
cassette case,
like a little cassette, you know?
Well, he didn't want to pick it up with his bare hands, so he probably scooped it up in a little cassette case and shut it and brought the little bird home. It'll fit in there.
But, you know, if you think of a hummingbird, it looks so much bigger than that, the way it beats its wings.
Yeah.
But it really would fit in a cassette case.
Yeah. Once they're closed up, once they stop flapping their wings, they're a little teeny tiny thing.
The size of a bumblebee.
I go back to the email. I know it's weird, but better than the assorted baby rattlesnakes, gigantic prehistoric scorpions, and horny toads, all alive, by the way, or the exploding rotten quail eggs. Don't even ask. And no, he's not trying to get rid of me. So apparently this guy finds things and then brings them into her. It's a way of showing.
A problem.
Well, there is treatment for that. Anyway, I put the hummingbird in the cassette case in the freezer so that I could take it out and look at it every now and then.
She has a problem,
because
too.
It's so pretty. Then I heard the Frozen Ted Williams song on your show and decided to look at my birdie. I took it out of the freezer, out of its Ziploc, wiped off the fog, and admired its pretty colors. Then I decided to look at the cassette cover to see which one it was. I knew it was a George Strait tape, but when I turned it over and looked at the sleeve, I felt a shiver run down my spine.
What was it?
I know this is eerie, and you're not going to believe it, but the tape was Chill of an Early Fall. Isn't that really weird?
It is weird. Oh, anyway, scary.
This whole thing's disturbing.
Thank you, Debbie, for signing that. And I wonder what kind of tape box they put Ted Williams in. Maybe it's this one.
Go on and open up the coffin. Put the man on ice. 'Cause baseball great Ted Williams' son thinks he could live twice. But Bobby Joe, Ted's daughter's kinda sad. She wants Ted's corpse cremated. She doesn't wanna freeze her dad. And he'll always be the greatest hitter ever. Could they recreate him? I think maybe probably never. And I'll always be a big old fan of his. So let us all try to remember good thoughts about old Ted. If they freeze his entire body, or if they only freeze his head. His son has gone completely mad. Bobby Joe, Ted Williams' daughter, just doesn't want to freeze her dad. When I told my kids, they thought it might be rad. But Bobby Joe, she don't think so. Tonight they're gonna freeze her dad.
What's your favorite radio station?
This is Tim and Willie in the morning, in the morning, in the morning, in the morning.
We are backstage at the Opry House, and all the hustle and bustle going on back here. A lot of excitement in the air now that the CMA Awards are over. Now, Alan Jackson couldn't win every award. It would have looked really odd if he won the female vocalist. There's no doubt about that. But Martina McBride won it, and it's not her first female vocalist, CMA. Although the last time she won one, I think she was a little more giddy and excited and chipper. This one was a little bit more emotional. Let's take a listen.
And the winner is Martina McBride.
I was not prepared for this emotion that I'm feeling. It's just so amazing that I get to live this dream. And I'm so grateful to everybody who worked so hard to make it happen. And I'm really especially happy because my mom and dad are here tonight. It just means so much to share this with them because they've just given me everything all my life and encouraged me and gave me unconditional love and support.
Unbelievable. There she is.
Now you're going to make me cry all over again.
If you cry, I'm crying. I don't care. Get me some Kleenex right now. Martina McBride, congratulations.
Thank you very much.
Wow.
Now, where are mom and dad right now?
They are right over there.
Oh, man, how great. Is that why it was a little more emotional tonight? Because they're here? Or what?
Yeah, and, you know, I didn't prepare anything to say, and that just is what came out when I got up there. And I was just really overwhelmed by the fact that they're here, and also just this, I don't know, I'm just really grateful that I am here and that I got to win the Female Vocalist Award again. I never expected... You know, I thought, well, I won one. That's good enough for me. Mm-hmm. I'm fine with that.
And
I
now
never
you're hooked, and you're going to want a third, and then you're going to want a fourth, and then you're going to be difficult to live with.
Is that what's going to happen?
No,
I hope
maybe.
Not.
No. Well, it was great, and I think you're one of those people I've just heard say again and again that, you know, getting to do what you do is oftentimes reward enough. The fans and the you know, selling records, that's all great. It must be something even special, more special, when the Country Music Association hands you the trophy and just says, you're it this year.
It really is. Yeah. It's an unbelievable feeling of acceptance and support and
think all those people got the ballots and they checked my name. It's just amazing. I really don't take it for granted. I'm really grateful.
Now, you had just performed Concrete Angel.
Mm-hmm.
Powerful, great song, and you really belted it out tonight. It was excellent.
You.
But as you're getting ready for this day, what's more nerve-wracking, coming knowing you have to kind of get up and sing in front of everybody and on TV, or knowing that you're going to have to sit there and wait and see if you won the award?
Oh, the performance is always nerve-wracking.
Yeah.
Because of your peers?
Because of your peers, and also because it's live TV, you know? Yeah. It's just live TV. And if you fall, if you trip over your dress and fall on the stage, there's really no recovering from that, you know? Sort of. There's no stopping the tape and starting over. You're just... So that's always what goes through my mind, is that you're going to forget the words or
something. Something just popped into my head. What year did you lay on the couch and sing? Do you remember?
That was... 94, 95.
Okay. I was worried that you might fall off of it.
So was I.
That would have been a little bit embarrassing. But going back to your speech tonight, I would rather hear you just get up there unprepared, same as Alan, and just let it flow, as opposed to somebody maybe that has the notes and all that prepared, because that's the real deal. That's three chords and the truth.
I was really unprepared. As a matter of fact, I said to John early on the show, I said, what am I going to say if I should win? I haven't even thought about what I'm going to say. So I was kind of unprepared. But so then what happens is, you just say what's in your heart.
That's it. Yeah. Well, great night for you and for your fans all around the country. And congratulations again. Martina McBride, CMA, Female Vocalist of the Year.
Tim and Willie in the morning.
Tim and Willie in the morning.
Hi, what can we do for you?
Could you please play...
That's two.
I Am Blessed.
Oh, that was the third one?
Yeah, that was three.
I only heard two.
Oh, there was three.
Yeah.
I think if we go back and we review the tape.
We're going to have to go back to review the
stop
tape.
Stop action, that there would be three ums.
Ah, too bad.
We have a three rule here. If you say three times, then I'm afraid we have to go.
We have to hit the trap door on you.
And we still love you.
Yeah.
But
we'll play your song, but yeah.
Next time you'll have to call up with two ums or less.
Bye.
Oh, that's four.
This is Tim and Willie in the Morning.